This video describes lesson number 5, Natural Vegetation and Wildlife, Module 2. In lesson number 5, Natural Vegetation and Wildlife, Module 1, let's recap what we have studied. In the beginning, we have studied about the meaning of natural vegetation and wildlife. Students, you all know that natural vegetation refers to the plant life that grows naturally in a particular region or in a geographical region. The plants that make up natural vegetation are valuable resources as they provide us timber, fruits, medicinal plants, shelter to animals, oxygen and protect soil and store water. So students, please remember that natural vegetation means the plant that has not been grown by humans. It does not need help from the humans and get whatever it needs from its natural environment. Also, we have studied about wildlife. Wildlife refers to undomesticated animal species, but has come to include all organisms that grow or live wild in an area without being introduced by humans. So here in the wildlife, human interference is not there. Students, also you all know that wildlife plays an important role in balancing the environment. Also, we have studied about natural vegetation and wildlife in Brazil. Let's take a quick recap. In natural vegetation in Brazil, we have studied that Brazil is gifted with the largest number of vegetation species in the world. Trees like Pau Brazil, rubber, mahogany, rosewood and a variety of orchids are found in Brazil. Due to abundant sunlight and heavy rainfall, vegetation grows with high speed. The life cycle and density of vegetation is found to be high in the north part of Brazil. Therefore, the northern part of Brazil is covered by dense forests. Also, we have studied that Brazil's vegetation can be classified as vegetation in the areas of high rainfall, vegetation in the areas of medium rainfall, and vegetation in the areas of low rainfall. In Brazil, certain economically important trees are also found in grassland along with the tall grasses. Then we have studied about wildlife in Brazil. Brazil is blessed with a rich wildlife. A great diversity in wildlife is found in Brazil than any other country in the world. Huge anacondas are found in Pantanal region. Guiana peak, crocodiles, alligators, monkeys, pumas, leopards are found in various parts of Brazil. Swordfish found in Atlantic Sea, pink dolphin and piranhas in the river. So student, here please remember that swordfish are found in Atlantic Sea, pink dolphin and piranhas found in rivers. Also, we have studied that huge size condors, various types of parrots, macaws, flamingos are the other major birds seen in Brazil. Lesson number 5, Natural Vegetation and Wildlife, Module 2. We will be learning about the natural vegetation and wildlife in India. What are the major causes of degradation of forests in India? And what environmental issues are faced by India? What are the measures taken for protecting wildlife in India? Let us study now natural vegetation in India.
When we talk about the natural vegetation of our country, that is India, it includes various types of forest in India. Let us study the classification of forest in India. Evergreen forest, deciduous type of forest, thorny and shrub forest, coastal forest, and the last we have the forest found in the Indian Himalaya. Let's take more information about evergreen forest. The evergreen forests in India are found in the region receiving abundant sunlight. So, abundant means the availability of sunlight is more in such region. Also, this region receive average rainfall more than 2000 mm. Highest biodiversity is found in this evergreen forest. Many species of vegetation and wildlife is also found in evergreen forest in India. The trees from evergreen forest have broad and grizzly leaves. Their wood is found to be hard, heavy and durable. Let's see where the evergreen forests are found in India. These evergreen forests are found in the Andaman and Nicobar Island, the Western Ghats, the coastal line of peninsula, and in the region of Assam in the northeast direction. Here we have the examples of trees of evergreen forest. Trees of evergreen forest such as mahogany, Indian rosewood, rubber tree, and sandalwood is also found in the evergreen forest in India. Deciduous forest. Student, please remember that deciduous forest, also known as deciduous type of vegetation. Deciduous type of vegetation is found in the region or the areas receiving rainfall between 1000 mm and 2000 mm. Deciduous type of vegetation is characterized by the trees that shed their leaves during dry or summer season. So, student, during dry and summer season, these trees are shedding their leaves. Shedding leaves decreases the rate of evaporation and it helps trees to conserve water and energy. This region experiences hot climate throughout the year. Deciduous forests receive maximum rainfall from the month of June to September. So, student, please remember that in most of the India, the amount of annual rainfall is between 1000 mm to 2000 mm. Therefore, the deciduous type of vegetation occupies most part of India. The trees found in deciduous forests such as teak, bamboo, banyan, and peepal also included in the trees of deciduous forest. Let's study in detail about thorny forest and shrub type of vegetation. The thorny forest and shrub type of vegetations are found in India in the region where the amount of average annual rainfall is less than 500 mm. Also, this region experiences dry summer for long period in India. The thorny trees and bushes from this forest have leaves that are very small and some leaves
turn themselves into thorny to prevent loss of water by the process of transpiration. So student, transpiration is a process in which plants release the water inside it in the form of moisture of water vapor. The thorny forest and shrub type of vegetation is mainly found in semi-arid area of Gujarat and Rajasthan. These forests are also found in Thar Desert. Trees of thorny forest and the shrub type of vegetation such as acacia, aloe vera, kejri is some type of vegetation found in the thorny type of forest. Coastal forest, also known as the coastal type of vegetation in India. In India, the coastal type of vegetation is found along the coast, the edges of deltas, estuaries, and swampy and marshy land. The wood of this tree is oily, light in weight, and durable. If we talk about the coastal forest in India, the coastal type of vegetation is mainly found along the western coast and the eastern coastal areas. Trees of coastal forest, mangroves and sundari trees are mainly found in these forests. Therefore, these forests are also known as mangroves or Sundarban. The trees in mangroves or the Sundarban have oily, durable and light in weight. So student, please remember that the trees that are found near the coastal areas, water body or the marshy land are called as the trees of the coastal forest. Himalayan forest. In Indian Himalayas, three types of forest are found according to the altitude. Let's see what they are. Higher altitude, medium altitude and foothills of Himalayas. So in Himalaya, the forests are found on the basis of altitude. Please remember, in Himalaya, the forests are found on the basis of altitude, such as higher altitude, medium altitude and foothills of Himalaya, also known as mixed vegetation. Now let's study in detail. Trees of Himalayan forest. Higher altitude. In areas located at the higher altitude, the climate is very cold. The temperature is almost 0 degrees Celsius throughout the year. As a result, this area is almost snow covered. For most of the days in a year, due to extreme cold vegetation, plants do not grow. During summer, snow melt as it affects some seasonal flowers to grow. During winter, again this tree extinct. Then we have the region with the medium altitude. In region with the medium altitude, coniferous trees like pine, devdar, fir are found. And the last, we have foothills of Himalayas. In the foothills of Himalayas, mixed forests are found. Coniferous, deciduous type of forest. Here, the proportion of salt trees is higher. Wildlife in India. India is also a mega diverse country in terms of wildlife.
There are many species of wildlife in India. Now let's take more information in detail about wildlife in India. Wildlife in India. Elephants are found in hot and humid forest. One horned rhino are found in swampy and marshy land of Assam. Wild ass and camels are also found in arid land, means in a desert region. Snow leopard and yak are found in the snow-capped region of Himalaya. In India is the only country in the world where tigers and lions are found on a large scale. But due to the deforestation and the hunting, the number of tigers and lions are decreasing day by day. Also, Indian bison, deer, antelopes, and monkeys are found in the part of the Indian Peninsula region. Rivers, estuaries, and the coastal areas are the home of many turtles, crocodiles, and gharials. The forest and the wetland are the shelter of variety of birds like peacock, kingfisher, Indian bustard, duck, and peasants. Other birds such as parakeets, cranes, and pigeons. These species make it a land of unique habitat of wildlife. Issues related wildlife and forest. Students, you all know that India is a mega diverse country in terms of wildlife. Various birds, animal species, insects, and creatures are found in our country. There are various species of wildlife, but India is facing several issues related wildlife and forest, such as deforestation. Deforestation is occurring rapidly, as you may know that to satisfy the needs of shelter and to obtain firewood, the trees are cut down on large scale in India. Deforestation has resulted into a loss of habitat for many of the species. As all of you are aware about the recent example about RA deforestation. Then another issue related to wildlife is the problem of pollution. The problem of pollution has become severe due to increased urbanization. Various types of pollution have threatened the life of many of the species. In India, the problem of illegal smuggling or poaching also occurs, and hunting of animal has increased on a larger scale. Various measures are taken to protect the wildlife and forest life in our country. Let's see what they are. The government of India has set up a number of national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, bird sanctuaries, and biosphere reserve for the protection of wildlife and forest in India. The main causes of extinction of wildlife are poaching. Innumerable animals and birds are hunted for meat, skin, ivory, and horn. So basically, the human beings are doing the hunting for the commercial purpose, or we can say for their own benefit. Wildlife sanctuaries are places where the killing and capturing of any animal is prohibited except under the order of the authorities concerned. The National Wildlife
action plan has been adopted in the year 1893 for the wildlife conservation. Many sanctuaries and national parks have been established for the protection of wildlife. So here we can see the example such as the Sanjay Gandhi National Park, the World Heritage Kaziranga National Park, and Dr. Salim Ali Bird Sanctuary. So the government has started taking initiative to protect the wildlife as well as the forest areas in a country. In lesson number 5, Natural Vegetation and Wildlife, let's recap what we have studied in module 2. So, in module 2, we have studied about natural vegetation and wildlife in India. Let's have a quick recap about natural vegetation in India. As you all know that India is blessed with a rich and diversified vegetation. Various kinds of vegetations are found in India. India's vegetation can be classified into evergreen forest, deciduous forest, thorny and the shrub type of forest, coastal forest and the forest found in the Indian Himalaya. Let's take quick recap. Evergreen forest. Evergreen forests are found in the region receiving abundant sunlight and average annual rainfall more than 2000 mm. The trees such as mahogany, rosewood, rubber, sandalwood are found in the evergreen forest. Then deciduous type of forest or vegetation. Such kind of forests are found in the areas receiving rainfall between 1000 mm and 2000 mm. Student, please remember that in most of India, the amount of annual average rainfall is between 1000 mm to 2000 mm. Therefore, the deciduous type of vegetation occupies most of the place in India. Then we have studied about thorny and the shrub type of forest. Thorny and the shrub type of forest are found in the state of Rajasthan, Gujarat and in the central part of the peninsula. The average annual rainfall received by this region is less than 500 mm. In India, we have studied about the coastal forest. The coastal forests are found along the coast, the edges of deltas, estuaries and the swampy land. In India, the coastal type of vegetation is mainly found along the western and the eastern coastal area. Mangroves and sundari trees are mainly found in this forest. Therefore, these forests are also known as mangroves or Sundarban. And at the end, we have studied about Himalayan forest. The Himalayan forest range are known as Himalayan forest. Himalayan forests are classified into three types on the basis of altitude. Altitude means height, such as the areas at higher altitude, the areas at medium altitude, and the areas at low altitude. Also, we have studied about wildlife in India. India is also a mega diverse country in terms of wildlife. There are many species of wildlife in India. Please remember that India is the only country in the world that has tigers as well as the lion. Then, deforestation, illegal smuggling and hunting, pollution and urbanization are the various problems related to the wildlife in India. To conserve the wildlife in India, the government has started taking initiative to protect the wildlife, to conserve the life of the animals and the forest. Government of India has set up a number of national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, bird sanctuaries, and biosphere reserve for the protection of wildlife and forests in India.